Let's assume one day you wake up and all the arithmetic operators like plus, minus, multiplication, division just vanishes. You just forgot how to use plus, minus, division, multiplication, let's say that also. Okay. But you remember all your CS knowledge, all your CS degree knowledge, how to use them. Okay. And you just encounter a problem that you have to add two numbers. Okay. But the condition lies that you forgot how to use add. Okay, you don't know the plus operator. Okay, what is this? What this plus operator does? So how will you add two numbers? Your teacher come to you say that just give me 1 plus 2. Okay, it should be 3. Okay, but you don't know how to use plus operator. Okay, or let's say that your teacher come to you and say that 1 2 3 4 plus 5 5 6. Okay. Just give me the addition of this, but you don't know the plus operator. So how you will do that? Okay, how you will bring the answer to your teacher and get your marks? Okay, let's say let's find that. Okay, so this is a question that is being asked in many of the interviews. Okay, and in many of the competitive programming sites like LeetCode, Geeks for Geek, HackerRank, HackerWorld, this question is in many of those sites. Okay. So how we will solve these questions? Okay. How we will solve addition, or how we will add two numbers without using the plus operator? So the question will be directly given to you. Add two numbers without using plus operator. Okay. So you have to do this. Okay. So let's say that you are given a variable A and variable B, and let's say that it is 1 and it is 2, and you have to find those things. So how will you do that? So this type of questions can be solved by using the bit manipulation. You have to get the knowledge of, if I hope that you know the knowledge of bit manipulation. Okay, you know what is AND gate, you know what is OR gate, you know what. Okay, so let's start with the basic. Okay, let's assume that we have been given two numbers 1 2 3. Okay. And 1 2 3, let's say that 1 2 3, and you have to add 4 5 6. Okay, and yes, this is the question in which you have to do. So firstly, what we will do, let me just have some type of query, sorry, carry. Yeah. So in our basic way, what we do, we just add 6 plus 4 is 10. So firstly, we will put 0 here, and we will keep a carry here, 1. Okay, then what we will do, we will add 5, 2 and 1, that will give us 8. So we will put 8 here. Okay, then we will add 4, 1. Okay, so output will be 5. Output will be 5. Okay, so you can see that we have a answer as 580, and this is the result of 580, but we don't want to use this plus operator. Okay. So how we can do that? So firstly, let's as you know the number system. Okay, we know that we have a number system of decimal. Okay, we have a number system of binary in which we only use 0 and 1, sorry. Binary in which we use only 0 and 1. Then we have hexadecimal and we have octal also. Okay, so we are not gonna focus on hexadecimal and octal, we are just gonna focus on the decimal and binary. Okay, so what we will do, what basically we are doing, so let us have a small number. Let's say that we have a number 1 and 3, we have to add them, so the output will be 4. So firstly, what we will do, we will convert 1 into a hexadecimal, sorry, binary. So it will be 0001. एंड थ्री विल बी जीरो, आई थिंक इट विल बी 0 0 1 0,
यस
एंड फोर आउटपुट विल बी, आई होप इट इज राइट, नो इट इज टू, दिस विल बी 0 0 0 0, या सो द आउटपुट ऑफ आर फोर शुड बी 0 1 0 0, सो दिस इज फोर, यस इट इज फोर. सो हाउ वी आर डूइंग दिस, हाउ वी आर बेसिकली सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन. ओके सो फर्स्टली लेट्स जस्ट कम एट दिस पॉइंट 0 0 0 1 एंड 0 0 1. ओके सो फर्स्टली वी गॉट टू डू, इन आर बिट ऑपरेशन वी हैव समथिंग एज और. ओके वी हैव समथिंग एज और, वी हैव समथिंग एज एंड वी हैव समथिंग एज एक्सोर. Okay, so I hope that you know the truth tables of all the three things. Let me show you what is the truth table of XOR 1 and 2. I have already created that. So XOR is the exclusive OR. So if you both of the elements are false or both of the elements are 0, it will give us 0. If either of the elements are 1, it will give us 1. And if both of the elements are 1, then it will give us 0. Okay, so that's why it is the exclusive OR. Okay, so it is just discarding the 1 plus 1. Okay. And if we come on the OR part, you can see that if both of the element are 0, it is giving 0. And if any one of them or both of them are 0, it is giving us 1. Okay, or sorry. If any of them or both of them are 1, then it is giving us 1. Okay, and in AND, what we are doing, if any of the elements are 0, it will give 0, and if both of them are 0, it will give us 0. So let's come to this point. Okay, so firstly what we will do, we will find the XOR. Okay, because we have written XOR at the top. So what XOR will do, we will always move from right to left. Okay, so 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1 is 0 in our case. 1 plus 1 is 0. Okay. So it will be 0. 0, 1, it will be 1. Okay. And 0, 0, 0. And 0, 0, 0. Okay. So this is something that we have got through XOR. Okay. Let's solve with the AND part. Okay. So 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. Okay. 1 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 0, 0. Okay. And this is using the AND. Okay. And now let us also solve using the OR operator. 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0, 0. And 0 plus 0, 0. This is using the OR operator. Okay. Now let's just add all these things. Okay. And these things without just focusing on our given result. Okay. So 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is basically what 1 plus 1. If you focus on the numerical in decimal, 1 plus 1 is 2. And 2 converted to, let's me write, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 2 converted into decimal, sorry, binary, it's 10. Okay. So what we can see that, we have 0 here. Okay, so let us not focus on this. So I will come at this point. I will put 0 at the unit place, and I will just place 1 as a carry here. Okay. Then I will again add 1 plus 0 plus 1. So it will add up to 2. 2 converted into binary, it is 10. Sorry, 10. So we will put 0 here. Okay. Again, we will put 1 here. So 0 plus 0 plus 1. It's add up to 1. Okay. So it's this. And then 0 plus 0 plus 1. it's zero. So we, what we will do, we will just put this zero there. Okay. So we don't have a carry here, so we will just mention zero here as a carry. So we can say that this is the carry. Okay. And if we just focus on the, what you can say, and sorry, XOR part. Okay, one sec. I think I have written something. Hold on. One plus one is zero. Okay. And then XOR is denoted by this sign, and is denoted by this sign, and OR is denoted by this sign. One sec. 1 plus 1 is 2, so 0 and 1, 1 is there. 1 plus 1 is, okay. Okay, so leave it. But we can see that our output here comes is 4. Okay, yeah, this is the case. Okay, so one sec. Let me once again focus, recheck all these stuff. Let me remove this OR because we are not gonna use that. What AND does is 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0. Sorry, this is 1. That's the thing I have written wrong. And the result from OR was, I have just, let me just, this was AND. I have just written the wrong name for them. Okay, so if we see the this thing, 001 0011 and 011, okay, so we can just see that if we find the AND of both of them, it's something equal to the AND part, but it is shifted once, one place. Okay, we have just popped out a number. Okay, let me just write it down here. 0011. So what we have just popped out the zero from the starting point. So we have 011 and we have added a zero. Okay, so this thing is called shifting. Okay, shifting a bit. So we have to just shift a bit by one. Yeah, we have just shifted a bit. And if we just focus on this part, 001. Okay, so we can see that XOR is somewhat equal to this thing. Okay, but this is not the exact answer. XOR is not the exact answer. We have to move in this same direction. We have to find all these things until our any of this result, any of this number, either the A or B becomes zero. Okay, so we just have to focus on AND and the OR operator. So sorry, AND and the XOR operator. So let's just remove the OR part. Okay, so let me just show you the code of this application, of this algorithm. Okay, so let's say that we have A is equal to 1, where B is equal to 2, okay, or 3. So we will just focus on that part. Okay, now what we will do, we will just have to use all the our carry operators, our bitwise operators. Okay, so we don't have to convert our numbers into a decimal, sorry, binary. Okay, we can directly use the XOR AND or XOR operator on the decimal number, and it will be resolved using the power of the programming language. Okay, so firstly what we will do, we will find the carry. So carry, how we have find the carry, we can see that carry is exactly the same as the AND part, but it is shifted by one. So firstly we will find the carry A B. So we have find the carry. Okay, now what we'll do, we will say that and. So now what we'll find, we will find the XOR of A and B, and we will just replace the value of A by the XOR of A and B. And now what we'll do, we will set the B as carry shifted to 1. As we have seen that we have find the carry and we have find this value, but we have to use these value. Okay, we have to set this value as A again, we have to set this value as B again. Okay, we have to shift and then shift it by 1. Okay, and then repeat this process, repeat the whole process of XOR and AND until B is not equal to 0. Okay, so what we will do, we will just place a while loop. Okay, and what we'll do, we will say that B is not equal to 0. This is the case, and after that we will just say that console.log A. Okay, save. And now let's just run and see what is the output. So node add to number. Okay, we got an error, unexpected token where. Okay, we haven't saved this. Okay, so you can see that the output is 4. The output is 4 and our answer is right. Okay, so let us go with the 10 and 30. And let's see what the output comes. Okay. So in this way, we can use this type of question. You can solve this type of question without using the plus operator. You can see that in our application, we haven't used any of the plus operator. So let's see, will it work on negative numbers? Okay, minus 10 and minus 30, will it work? And if yeah, it is working, because bit shifting works on every number, any type of number that you are passing. Okay, so because if you will convert this number to binary, you will convert this negative number to binary, then it will work according to that. Let us do this. 30 plus minus 10, you can see that we got 20. Okay, so this is a way in which we can solve our question using bit operators. Okay, but we can also solve this thing using recursion. So your task is to solve this question using recursion. Okay, and just comment your answer in the description below. In the comment section, and I will check whether your solution is right or wrong. Okay, and you can also use this technique to solve subtraction also and multiplication also. You have to just focus on the bit operators, and this description, this will be given in the description below. You can check this out if you want any of the help from this thing. So that's all for today. Thank you.